Deuteronomy, we'll read a verse there. We did good when we were practicing. But as I have said, it's for the Lord. I hope you heard the message of this song, especially at the chorus. Numbers tell me more than this. In Deuteronomy chapter 6, the Bible says, verse number 5. Deuteronomy 6:5, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. If you go to Mark chapter 12, verse number 30, my life verse, Mark chapter 12, verse number 30, the Bible says, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for loving us first of all. Lord, help us this morning as we come before your holy presence to hear the teaching and the preaching of your word. Lord, I pray that you will use this message this morning for us to take an inventory of our love to you. Lord, I pray that this morning our love for you will be scrutinized because of the message. Dear Holy Spirit, please do the work today. I want to be a blessing to God's people, but I cannot do that on my own. Holy Spirit, please do it. Help us, Lord, this morning that through the message that each one of us will love our Lord, not with the kind of love that we want to give him, but with the kind of love that he deserves, being our Savior, our Lord, and our God. Bless your servant. Bless your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, everyone. Doon sa binasa ni Brother Ray earlier, here in the passages in John chapter 21, verses 15, down to verse number 18. Actually, the story starts with verse number 1. And in those verses that we read earlier with Brother Ray, the Lord Jesus Christ asked Peter. He said, Peter, do you love me? Remember, Peter just denied the Lord Jesus Christ. He denied the Lord Jesus Christ. And now Jesus Christ asked him, he said, do you love me? And of course, Peter said, yes, Lord, I love you. And Jesus asked him again the second time, sabi ng Panginoon doon sa verse number 16, he said to him the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest of me? Lovest of me? And he said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. And he said unto him, feed my sheep. Verse number 17, he said unto him the third time. Tanong ng Panginoon is, Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest of me? And the Bible says that Peter was grieved because he said to him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said to him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. And Jesus said unto him, feed my sheep. I have a question for you this morning. Do you love the Lord Jesus Christ? Amen. Let me repeat the question. Do you really love the Lord Jesus Christ?
Amen.
The third question is different. Do you really, really love the Lord Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Now, Peter had a remark that was true. Sabi ni Peter dito, Lord, thou knowest all things. Was that true?
Amen.
Thou knowest all things. Folks, friends, the Lord knows everything. The Lord knows your heart. I ask you a question, do you love Jesus? And you said, yes. But Jesus knows your heart. And Jesus knows if you really, really love Him or not. Sometimes when I observe, pag tinitignan ko yung buhay ng maraming mga Christian, I've been in the ministry by the grace of God for over 30 years. And as I look at the lives of many believers, I fear that we do not demonstrate that love for our Lord as we should. We say we love the Lord, and probably you're right. Probably you're telling the truth. But sometimes we do not demonstrate our love for Him as much as we should. And I wish na itong message natin ngayong umaga will help us re-evaluate or examine or scrutinize, or it will help us to take an inventory of our love for our God. Gaano ba talaga natin kamahal ang Panginoon? And when we talk about loving our Lord, the question is this: what kind of a love our Lord deserves? Anong klaseng pagmamahal? What kind of love is He worthy of? Are you giving Him the love that He is worthy of? Yes, maybe you are, yes, you are probably right, you love Him. But let us go deeper. Are you giving our Holy God? Are you giving our Lord Jesus Christ, the greatest lover of all, the kind of love that He deserves? Are you giving Him that kind of love? Or are you giving Him the love that you want to give Him? Like, I love my wife. Am I giving the love na talagang yung kung yung gusto ko lang na ibigay? Or am I giving her the love that she rightfully deserves? That is the question that we should ask ourselves. Well, what kind of love is that? Number one, we should love the Lord with absolute devotion. We should love the Lord with absolute devotion. Now, we should love the Lord with absolute devotion, or we should love the Lord devotedly because of what the Lord Jesus Christ did. Amen? Amen? Because of what the Lord Jesus Christ is doing, and because of what the Lord Jesus Christ will do for us. In our Friday school earlier, we had a great time. We sang the song, "My Jesus, I Love Thee." It's in your notes. We started our Friday school just talking about loving the Lord Jesus Christ. In fact, 30 minutes, half of our time was spent on talking about loving the Lord Jesus Christ. And I remember in our Friday school, we were giving reasons why they love the Lord. And then they also uttered reasons, how do we demonstrate our love for the Lord Jesus Christ? In 1 John chapter 4, verse number 19, the Bible says this. Look at your Bible, 1 John chapter 4 and verse number 19. 1 John chapter 4, verse number 19. The Bible says here, we love Him because what? He first loved us. We love Him because He first loved us. Romans chapter 5, verse number 8, the Bible says, but God commended His love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, what? Christ died for us. Folks, I'm telling you this morning, we should love the Lord devotedly. We should love the Lord with absolute devotion. Hindi lang po yung pagmamahal natin na nais natin ibigay sa Panginoon. Ibigay natin sa Panginoon yung pagmamahal na kung saan karapat-dapat na para sa Kanya. Amen? We should love our Savior with the love that He deserves. It is an absolute devotion. We should love Him because of what He did. Alam niyo, this morning, I hope she won't mind. But again, we were having a testimony, and I said, would you give me some reasons why you love the Lord? And we started with Brother Sam, and then when Sister Lou began to speak, she was in tears, and she said, na ngayon niya lang daw na-realize, sa edad niya niya, I do not know how old she is, sa edad niya niya, 64 or something? And she said, I just realized how much God has done for me. And she was in tears. Because she realized what Jesus did for her. You know, if you will only realize what God did for you, if you will only take some time to ponder or to realize, to think about what our God did for you, what the Lord Jesus Christ did for you and I, folks, we will give Him or we will love Him with an absolute devotion. There is a story in the Bible. Turn your Bibles, please, to 2 Samuel. This is back in the Old Testament. 2 Samuel chapter 19. 2 Samuel chapter 19. 2 Samuel chapter 19. 2 Samuel chapter 19. It starts with verse 1 to 24 down to verse number 30. Let me just read these verses. 24 down to verse number 30. And Mephibosheth, the son of Saul, came down to meet him, and had neither dressed his feet, nor trimmed his beard, nor washed his clothes from the day the king departed until the day he came again in peace. And it came to pass, when he was come to Jerusalem to meet the king, that the king said unto him, wherefore wentest not thou with me, Mephibosheth? And he answered, my lord, O king, my servant deceived me. For my servant said, I will saddle me an ass, that I may ride thereon, and go to the king, because thy servant is lame. Mephibosheth was lame. Hindi po siya nakakalakad. And he had slandered thy servant unto my lord the king. But my lord the king is an angel of God. Do therefore what is good in thine eyes. I want you to look at verse number 28 very closely. For all of my father's house were but dead men before my lord the king. Yet didst thou set thy servant among them that did eat at thine own table. What right therefore have I yet to cry any more unto the king? And the king said unto him, why speakest thou any more of thy mothers? I have said unto Ziba, divide the land. And Mephibosheth said unto the king, yea, let him take all, for as much as my lord the king is come again in peace unto his own house. Mephibosheth, the Bible says, was the son of Saul. He was lame. Saul was the enemy of David. Saul was the king who wanted to kill David. Now when David became king, all the family, all the sons of Saul were murdered. Pero alam niyo anong ginawa ni David? He spared Mephibosheth. The lame man. He spared him. Not only that he spared him, he brought him to his palace. And he took care of him. And he fed him. Gave him everything that he needed. Ganun ang ginawa ni David kay Mephibosheth. He did something to Mephibosheth that Mephibosheth did not deserve. It was all because of the kindness and the goodness and the love of the king. And alam nyo, ano nangyari doon? Dahil sa ginawa ni David, napamahal si David kay Mephibosheth. Mephibosheth loved King David so greatly. When Absalom rebelled and David ran for his life, Sheba, the servant of Mephibosheth, saw Goliath, kasi sabi isa, sasama niya daw si Mephibosheth, papunta doon kay King David, but he left him. He left him. Siniraan niya pa si Mephibosheth to King David. And so David had parang din nagkaroon siya ng bitterness against Mephibosheth. Because to him, Mephibosheth was disloyal. He was unfaithful. But you know what? From the time that David left Jerusalem and left his throne, the Bible tells us that Mephibosheth never shaved his beard, never took a bath. He was mourning for David. And then when David came, he was very excited. He explained his sorrow. But he loved David. You know why? Because of what David did for him. Folks, pondering upon what the Lord did for us will cause us to love him with absolute devotion. Sometimes we do not love the Lord devotedly. Why? Because we never think of what the Lord did for us. Remember, we are sinners. Amen? The Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible tells us there is none righteous, no one. The Bible tells us, for the wages of sin is death. Folks, we deserve to die and go to hell and burn in hell forever and ever. Why? Because we sinned against God. Amen?
Amen.
But you know what that means? For God so loved the world, He loved you and I. That He gave His only begotten Son, He sent the Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ left the splendor of heaven. He left His Father in heaven. He came to this wicked world. And for 33.5 years, the Lord Jesus Christ lived in this sinful world, and yet wala siyang ginawang kasalanan. And when the time came, you know what they did to the Lord Jesus Christ? You remember how the Lord Jesus Christ was arrested? They arrested him, they took him unfairly, and then they mocked him, and then they scourged him, and then they crucified him, they nailed him on the cross. And for 6 long hours he was on the cross, bruised and blood, lower his blood. He died a very shameful death, and he died a very painful death. Why did he have to do that? My friend, the Lord Jesus Christ did all that so that you and I won't have to go to hell. Amen?
Amen.
Ginawa ng Panginoon lahat yan so that hindi ka mapunta sa impyerno. And after doing all those things, hindi pa rin sa tapos. Hanggang ngayon, tinutulungan pa rin tayo ng Panginoon. He keeps us safe every day. Amen?
Amen?
He provides for us. He protects us. He answers our prayers. He is in heaven making intercessions for us. Amen. And one day, Jesus Christ, the Bible says, is coming back.
Amen.
Right now, He is preparing a place for you and I. And one day, Jesus Christ will come and He will take us all eternal home.
Amen.
Lahat ang ginawa ng Panginoon. Para sa iyo, have you pondered upon what Jesus Christ did for you? Have you meditated? Have you thought of what Jesus Christ is doing for you right now? Have you ever considered what the Lord Jesus Christ will do again for you in the future? Folks, if you will ponder upon what the Lord did for you, you will love Him devotedly. Amen?
Amen.
Love that kind of love will show in our life. Kung totoong mahal mo ang Panginoon, it will become very evident in your life. Amen?
Amen?
That will reflect in your life if you really love the Lord. It will show. It will show in your prayer life. So yung pagpapahalaga ng salita ng Panginoon, hindi mo kasi pwedeng mahalin ang Panginoon, hindi ka naman pre-pray. Hindi mo pwedeng mahalin ang Panginoon without loving His Word. If you love God, you will spend time in His Word. Amen?
Amen.
You will never too busy for the Word of God. If you really love the Lord, it will show even in your attendance with our worship services. It will show. It will show. If you love the Lord, you don't come to church. Amen?
Amen.
But if you love an activity more than coming to church, then there is a big question mark in your love to the Lord. Of course, there are times na talagang kailangan nandun ka. Sometimes your company will maybe obligate na magtrabaho. Or today, halimbawa, yung mga kids, meron silang mga ano sa school. We understand that. We understand that. We understand that. Alam din ng Panginoon niya. Alam ng Panginoon kung ano yung talagang score sa puso mo. If you love your sports more than you love church, I wonder if you really love the Lord. If you love your career, if you love your job, if you love your family more than you love God, that is not loving that devoted day. If you really, really love the Lord, that will show in your prayer life, that will show in your attention to the scripture, that will show in your attendance to church, that will show in your witnessing, that will show in your manner of life. Because loving the Lord with absolute devotion cannot be hidden. Amen?
Amen.
Folks, hindi mo po pwede may tago yan eh. Have you seen Brother Bernal? In love na in love yan eh. Amen?
Amen.
Talagang hindi niya may tago eh. Halatang-halatang na in love eh. Amen?
Amen.
Tinamaan ko pinu talaga eh, matindi. And last night, I pick him up after Bible study and we were talking about his wedding. Did you have him? Okay? Do you know anything about this, sister? Ikaw, babagitin yung pangalan ni Sita Mary. Nabanggit niya na. But I'm telling you, you can tell that Brother Bernal is in love. Amen?
Amen.
Of course, he's in love several times before, but this is it now. And if you are truly in love with the Savior, it will show. It will tell all of you. Now, let me ask you this question as we get this first part. What does your life say about your love for the Lord? What does your life say about your love for the Lord? Yung ating buhay, yung ating testimony. What does it say about our love for the Lord? Folks, number one, the Lord deserves, He is worthy of our devotion. Absolute devotion. Total devotion to the Lord. And number two, we should love the Lord not only with absolute devotion, but we should love the Lord, secondly, with absolute dedication. Absolute dedication. Now, our dedication to our Lord is demonstrated by forsaking the world and following Him. Amen?
Amen.
You agree? Amen?
Amen?
Let me say it again. Yung ating dedication sa ating Panginoon, our dedication to our Lord is demonstrated by forsaking the world and by following Him. Halimbawa, if you are a husband, sa mga husband na tayo today, do you love your wife? Okay. If you truly love your wife, tatalikuran mo lahat ng mga babae na nandyan. Amen?
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Regardless of how pretty they are. Amen?
Amen.
Nasa office ka, halimbawa, mababang mo ang sekretary mo. Si misis mo sa bahay naman, palaging nakakarnar na. Okay? Pero if you really love your wife, you will forsake other women. And they say, this is true with ladies. Ladies, do you love your husbands? Bakit si misis lang ang amen? Maraming babae ang sinag-amen yata. Hindi ko rin nakita si sister doon na nag-amen. Do you love your husband? But if you love your husband, huwag ka lang titingin sa ibang mga lalaki, amen? At ang mga lalaki, ganun din. Huwag ka lang mag-a-appreciate kung mayroon ina-appreciate mo yung ibang mga ladies. Huwag mo lang banggitin. In your mind, in your heart, you should be dedicated. You should be devoted to your wife. Jesus said in 1 Peter chapter 2, look at that. Tingnan natin ito. I'm saying, our dedication to our Lord is demonstrated by forsaking the world and following Him. Look at your Bible in 1 John chapter 2 and verse number 15. We know this verse. The Bible says, love not. Let's read the verse all together. Ready? Begin. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. And verse number 16 says, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but of the world. If you really love the Lord, you will forsake the world. Amen?
Amen.
You will forsake the world. Pero mayroong mga Kristiyano, they are like Demas. Tinalikuran nila ang Panginoon because of the world. Look at the Bible in 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse number 10. The Bible tells us about a man, about a Christian. I'm not saying that he's a bad Christian or whatever, but the Bible says in verse number 10, for Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed into Thessalonica, presence to Galicia, and Titus to Dalmatia. The Bible says, Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world. Now the child of God must always be aware, lest the chaos of this world steal our love for the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me say that again. Tayong mga anak ng Panginoon, dapat mag-ingat tayo. We should be careful lest the cares of the world will steal our love for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Marami kasing pwedeng mag-choke doon sa ating pagmamahal sa Panginoon. And you know what? Yung ating nangyayari, gradually, it doesn't happen overnight. It's like Lot in Genesis chapter 13. He looked toward Sodom, but he was living in Sodom. A Christian who loves the world does not love God. Hindi mo pwedeng mahalin ang sanlibutan at ang Panginoon at the same time. You cannot love the world and love God at the same time. You cannot love the world and love the Lord Jesus Christ at the same time. Jesus said, if you love the world, the love of the Father is not in you. Any desire that will eclipse our desire for God is sin. It is wrong. Any desire. Kung ano man yung mga desire natin sa puso that will eclipse our desire for God. Nawalan ka na ng gana sa Panginoon. Nawalan ka na ng desire sa Panginoon because of your desire for other things. Hindi po tama yun. Amen?
Amen?
Kung ano man yung mga bagay na yan, it is choking. Or it is robbing God of the love that He deserves. Ano yung mga desire na yun? It's probably making a living. Okay? Or work. Now you should love your work. Amen?
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 Amen.
Don't get me wrong. You should love your work. Kayong mga members ng Great Baptist Church, you should be the best na employee in Qatar. You should excel to be the best na employee in your company. Dapat na yan. Pero hindi natin dapat hayaan yung ating mga trabaho that will eclipse our God for God, our love for God. Hindi dapat nawawala yung ating pagmamahal sa Panginoon dahil sa ating pagmamahal sa ating trabaho. Do your job, but God should be number one in our heart. Amen? The Lord should be number one in our heart. Dapat siya number one sa puso natin. It's probably making a living or recreation or whatever it is. When these things take us away from the presence of the Lord, then we are in trouble spiritually. We are in trouble spiritually. We have to live in this world that is a path. Okay? We are living in planet Earth. Amen?
Amen.
You live in this world. Walang problema doon.
If you live in the world, walang problema doon. There's no problem with that. And there is no escaping of the truth either. But the problem is when the world lives in us. Yun ang problema doon. So number one, we should love the Lord with absolute devotion. Number two, we should love the Lord with absolute dedication. Dapat taliguran natin ang sanlibutan. The lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. The Lord should be number one in our life. Amen? Amen. The song we sang earlier, the song says, bakit nila tilakas yung message lang nun. Let me just recite the song again. The song says, modern times has brought us many comfort. We are living in an age of too much comfort. Diba? It's not like before. Nung maliliit kami, you need water, you go and fetch water 1 kilometer away. Ganun din ba sa inyo dati nung maliliit pa kayo? Ay, when we need water before, talagang we need to go very far. Meron artisanal doon. And meron kami mga, anong tawag nila? Kawaya? And then merong nilalagay namin ng E and then gulong ng mochineras. And then, yun, tinatry namin to get water. Yes. When paggagamit ka ng toilet, what do you do? Punta ka doon sa likod ng bahay, doon sa mga saking may toilet doon. Ganun din ba sa inyo dati? But now you need water, all you have to do is turn on the faucet. Okay? You need to do it, it's inside your room. Modern times has brought us many comfort. People live in wealth and luxury. But the Master still asks this question. Ito pa rin yung tanong ng Panginoon, do you love me more than this? Kasi nangyari itong story in John chapter 21, after the Lord Jesus Christ died and he was buried, Peter and the disciples went back to fishing. They were asleep and the Lord Jesus Christ went to them again. And then, nung nasa tabi na sila ng dagat, then Jesus asked Peter, he said, Peter, do you love me more than this? Peter, do you love me more than fishing? Peter, do you love me more than your career? Pero kung ikaw ang tinatanong ng Panginoon na yun, ano yung sasagot mo sa kanya? Do you love the Lord more than your career? Do you love the Lord more than those material things? Lovest thou me more than this, my child? What will your answer be? And then the answer is, O precious Lord, I love thee more than all of this. More than fame, more than wealth, more than this world. Amen?
Amen.
I love thee more than this whole world could offer. All sinful follies I deny for thee. My love, my life, my all, I pledge thee. I love thee, Lord. I love the Lord more than this. Folks, the Lord deserves our absolute devotion. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. And then secondly, we should love the Lord with absolute love. Dedication. And finally, we should love the Lord with absolute delight. With absolute delight. May kagalakan. Amen?
Amen?
All of us understands the feeling of expecting a loved one. Diba kung pauwi ka tapos malayo ka sa wife mo or sa husband mo, pauwi ka, na-remember mo yung excitement na makita mo yung iyong sinisinta for you to see the person you love very much. Amen?
Amen?
You still remember the feeling? Buti pa itong bata, di pa tapos ang prinsip, nag-forward na para sa invitation. Amen?
Amen?
Nasa second point pa lang tayo, pero nag-forward na.
Amen.
Sana ganyan din tayo. Tinuturoan tayo ni Juan ng lesson. Katulad nung parang din sa misis, talaga excited ako eh. Pero mas lalo excited siya. Hindi siya makatulog eh. And
I clean the house, I talagang, I wash the clothes, everything. Walang kahit isang maruming dami. I tried to clean the house. Why? I was excited. The woman I love is coming. Yung excitement, yung thrill. By the way, ganun din ang nararamdaman ni Brother Roland ngayon.
Amen.
So, kung ano yung kwento-kwento yung tungkol sa mga Indian Carnera. Excited tayo. We want to see the person we love. Amen? You know what? One of these days, the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. Babalik ang ating Panginoon. Folks, we should long for the day when we hear the heavenly shout. Because the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, tignan nyo dyan, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, out of this verse, these verses, the Bible says in verse number 13, but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that is ordered, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so that also we sleep in Jesus, will God bring with him. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. Look at verse number 16. The Bible says, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Look at 17. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Folks, someday we will see Jesus. Makikita natin ang ating Panginoon. We should have that longing in our heart to see and be with our Savior. Do you have that longing in your heart? Are you happy to see the Savior?
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
I hope you are. Maliban na lang kung meron ka pang mga unconfessed na mga kasalanan in your heart. Halimbawa, parating sinisismo. Pero alam mo, may ginagawa ng hindi niya pa alam. Would you be excited na parating sinisismo? Ha? Kung ikaw, or you are the wife, parating ang husband mo, pero meron kang affair sa iba. Ano nararamdaman mo? Instead na magiging excited ka, nandun yung takot, there is fear in your heart. Amen? Amen?
Amen?
Because you are doing something that's wrong. There is a sin in your heart. But folks, kung talagang walang kasalanan na nandyan, kung talagang if you love the Lord with absolute devotion, you love Him with all your heart, we love Him with all your soul, you love Him with all your mind, you love Him with all your strength, then you will be excited for the coming of our Savior. Amen?
Amen?
And so we should love the Lord with absolute delight. And you know, it is sin, yung kasalanan na nasa puso natin, will keep us from loving the Lord with absolute delight. Minsan, there is no excitement in our love for God. Why? Because we are nursing some sins in our heart. And the way to love the Lord with absolute delight is to confess every sin na nasa puso natin. So that when the Lord Jesus Christ comes, we are excited, we are ready to meet Him. Amen?
Amen?
My question for you this morning is this. Does your life demonstrate genuine devotion to the Lord? Does your life as a Christian demonstrate genuine dedication to the Lord? Is there excitement in your heart to see the Savior? Is there delight in your heart? You want to see the Savior? Look at your Bible in Revelation chapter 22. Let's read one more verse and then before we go to class. Revelation chapter 22 and verse number 20. Revelation chapter 22 and verse number 20. The Bible says here, Let me start with the 18. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book, if any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall take away his part of the book of the book of life, and out of the holy city, and from the things which are written in this book. Look at verse number 20. He which testifieth these things saith, surely I come. Ang Panginoon ang may sabi niya. Sinasabi ng Panginoon, surely I will come. Never doubting the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Folks, Jesus is coming back. Amen?
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 Amen.
He is coming back. Jesus made a promise. He said, I will go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, what did he say? I will come again. Amen? And receive you unto myself, that where I am, that ye may be also. He said, surely I come quickly. Amen. And look at the next few words here. Even so, come Lord Jesus. Ito ba? Even so, come Lord Jesus. Talagang pinag-pray pa rin na. Dito, ni John is saying, even so, come Lord Jesus. Would you be excited to see the Lord next year? Amen? 2014? Would you be excited to see the Lord Jesus Christ this year? Di ba exciting kung babalik ang Panginoon this year? Amen? Before December? Would it be exciting to see the Lord Jesus Christ before this month ends? Brother Bernal won't. Ang prayer ni Brother Bernal is, Lord, huwag mo na ngayon. Antay-antay na muna, this way, this way. But you know, if you really love the Lord, you will be excited to see Him. You know, there are so many people I'd like to see in heaven. I'm excited to see my mom. My mother passed away. She went home in 2005. My father went home to be with the Lord in the year 2000. I miss them. There are Bible characters that I want to see in heaven. I want to see the Apostle Paul. I want to see Moses in the Bible. Talagang, I'd like to interview Moses. I want to speak to Noah. I want to speak to Job. I want to speak to those great Bible characters in Elijah. Gusto kong matanong yung experience nila when they crossed the Red Sea. Daniel, when he was in the lion's den. I want to see those great men in the Bible. Pero alam niyo kung sino talaga ang gusto kong makita doon. You know who I want to see, first of all, when I go to heaven? I want to see my Savior. I want to see my Savior. I want to hug Him. I want to see His hands. I want to see His head. I just want to sit by His side and thank Him. I'm telling you that I love Him. I long to see my Savior, first of all. Do you have that genuine love for God? Are you genuinely devoted to the Lord and dedicated to the Lord? Are you looking forward to see Him? I hope that through this message, as I said earlier, we will examine our hearts. Are you giving our Lord the love that He deserves? Love, Heavenly Father, we thank You for this short message, Lord, that You gave us, Lord, today. Lord, we realize that many lives we do not love You with the love that You deserve, for that we ask for Your forgiveness. Lord, give us grace. Holy Spirit, empower us. So we can love our Savior this way, with absolute devotion and with absolute dedication and with absolute delight, with a thrill in our hearts, with a longing in our hearts, with a craving in our heart to see a and to be with our Savior who loved us and gave himself for us. Lord, if there's anyone here today that's not saved, Lord, I pray that you will work in our hearts. And Lord, for those who are already saved, Lord, help us to examine our hearts today and to examine our love for you. Help us, Lord, to see if we have loved something or someone more than we love you. And Lord, I pray that you will help us correct that problem today. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Every head bowed, every eye closed, no one looking around. Habang tayo po ay natayo ng ating mga ulo, nakikita ng ating mga mata. While every head bowed and eyes are closed, nobody looking around, nobody talking, nobody walking, nobody standing yet. My question is, are you loving the Lord with the love that He deserves? Folks, it is wrong. It is sinful to love Him less than the love He deserves. Kasi ang sabi ng Panginoon, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all your heart, your soul, your mind, your strength. Kung nagkulang tayo, if we do not love the Lord that much, the altar is open for you today. Why don't you come and say, Lord, I know I have not been loving you as much as I should, but Lord, I want to begin today. Lord, give me the grace. Lord, help me do it. Help me to love Him with an absolute devotion, with an absolute dedication, and with an absolute delight. Is there a sin in your heart today? Kaya hindi ka ganun excited, you are not excited when we speak of the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. There is no excitement in your heart because of some sins na naandun sa puso natin. Why don't you come this morning and confess that sin to the Lord? So that yung iyong fear sa puso will be replaced with excitement to see the Savior. You come today. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for your message that you have given us, for the truth that you allowed us to hear. Lord, I pray that you will bless the invitation. Give us a revival, Lord, in our church. And in every one of us, help us make decisions today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So we all stand. Would you come? The piano is playing right now. Would you come? Lumapit kayo rin to sa altar. Yung mga kaupo na yung kaka. Dito kayo sa taas. Why don't you come this morning and take an inventory of your love to the Lord? Take an inventory of your love to the Lord. Use the Word of God to measure your love for the Lord. Do you really love the Lord? There are three questions. When Jesus asked Peter, he said, Peter, do you love me? And then the second time, to me, parang sinasabi ng Panginoon, Peter, do you really love me? And then the third time, it was serious. When Jesus said, sa akin ganitong natingin, Peter, do you really, really Jesus is asking you the same question today. Our African brothers, what will you do with the message? Do you love the Lord as much as you should? Do you love Him with the love that He deserves? Would you come? Just step out of your seat. The Lord sees if you take one step. For our Filipino brothers, would you come today? Picture the Lord Jesus Christ is standing right in front of you right now. Close your eyes, bow your head. And picture the Lord Jesus Christ is standing right in front of you and asking you the same question. Tinatanong ng Panginoon sa iyo. Pangitin mo muna yung pangalan mo. The Lord asks you this question. Do you love me? Do you love me? More than this. More than your career. More than your children. More than your ambition. More than your leisure time, your recreation, or more than anything. More than fame. More than wealth. And then the Lord Jesus Christ asks you the question again. question is, do you really love me? Do you really love me? And again, he would ask that question, do you really, really love me? Parang sinasabi ng Panginoon dito kay Peter, Peter, if you really love me, why do you choose fishing more than me? Kung totoong mahal mo ako, bakit mas pinili mo pa yan? And so the Lord said, Peter, if you really love me, you will fill my ship. If you really love me, you will not be interested with fishing. You will be interested with filling my ship. That is the problem. Sinasabi natin, mahal natin ang Panginoon. But what are you doing about the work of God? What do you do about the work of God? If you really love the Lord, you will finish it. You will help the work of the Lord to grow. Folks, let us love the Lord with the love that He deserves. Absolute devotion, absolute dedication, and absolute delight. Delight because we have confessed every known sin that is in our life. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the message that you have given us again tonight. Lord, thank you that you have given us the opportunity na makapunta sa church upang marinig namin, Panginoon, ang iyong salita. Lord, help us to love you. Help us to love you. Lord, be patient with us. Holy Spirit, please empower us so we can love our Savior more and more each day. This is our prayer and our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much. You may go back to your seats. Let me ask Brother Jemmer. In the program, this is Brother Chester, but he knows his voice. So Brother Jemmer will come instead and sing for us a song. Somebody heard your special number last week, Brother Jemmer, and they are asking for a copy of the song. Who is Brother Kevin? He said, can I have a copy of that song? I want to play it in my taxi. And we advise him what to do. So, we'll ask Brother Jemmer to come and sit for us again. Brother Roland, would you please come here?
Brother Ray,
I just want to show. Sister says, I'll be making a tarpaulin ito or ito na yan.
Susolwin, okay. Pastor.
Would you ask, Sister Cecil?
Solwin po, nagsusolwin. Nagsusolwin.
Ah, susolwin. I'm very sorry. Ito yung ano, ito yung... Ano? Brother Bernal? Gawang tayong ano dito, tarpaulin na. Pakitaas lang ng bote. Let me show you, this is the Baptization Hunting Missions offering. Yung yellow, this is 2011, and yung blue, this is 2012, and 2013. Our conference was last August, and so we start at September, October, November. So ito yung 2013. Last year, nakikita nyo, every, nakikita nyo yung jump ng ating faith dito, pati stretch ng mountain. Yeah. No, first year, nandito lang tayo. But during the second year, on the same month, almost double yung faith natin dyan. And then sa October, ito, almost double every month, it's fine. Nakikita niyo, except for the month of January, we increase pa rin yung ating faith dito, pero not as much as yung other months. And so, next week, we will follow this third line. As of now, Brother Philip, I think the report given was nasa 18,000 tayo. Plus the missions giving we will give today. So, I do not know kung aabot tayo ng 30,000 or I do not know kung hanggang saan tayo dyan. So, this will be followed this week. Para may pakita natin yung progress. Not only with our giving, but our faith. Okay? Compared sa last 3 years. And so, on October again, dito ulit dyan. So, we just want to show you this. And maybe we have a tarpaulin para mas madaling kulayan na. Okay? Ilalagay natin ito every first Friday of the month. So, you will see the increase in our faith. Okay? Make sure you give to the Lord, but take care of that first. Give your tithes and offering for the ministry here, and of course your recognitions for our missionaries. Okay, let me ask Brother Jimmy to please come and pray for the offering. And Brother Jimmy, let me borrow your card. And please, if you know your code, it says here, this card, the code is, this is Sister March, her code is 1030. Six. Hindi naman nila may mura. May code dito. May number dito. If you can write that in your envelope. Now, I encourage you, write your name in the envelope. Okay? Because starting with September, I'm making my own file. I have a notebook. I write all the names and then the offerings of each one. I just want to do it myself. Brother Jeffers, do it. Patuloy niyo lang yun. So, write your name in the envelope. Okay? Nobody will know. When you are giving up, all they do is take up the money. They don't know about the names. But I want to have a copy. Okay? The Bible says that the pastor should know the state of the flux. And that's very important on my part. So please write your name. And if you have a card like this one, write the code also. I don't know my code. I have to check it now and start doing it. Okay? Please do that also. Okay? So, Brother Jimmy, you pray for the offering. Are you ready to give? Amen? Amen. And Brother Jimmy will come. That's all it's time.
Pray, O Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for a message that we have heard. O Lord, help us to love you dedicatedly, devotedly, and in the life, O Lord. O Lord, we thank you for the opportunity of being able to give your word, O Lord. Bless our jobs. Continue to give us time, O Lord. Work again, O Lord, and earn more so that we'll be able to support your work, O Lord. O Lord, bless everyone. In Jesus' name we pray.